Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Sean Locke, Victoria Corin Mitchell, Henning Zane, Tom Allen, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
To 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. It's all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, fantouche is a word used mainly by Scottish people to show extreme pleasure? For example, fantouche, I found another viable vein in my big toe. Guinea pigs aren't pigs and don't come from Guinea. Lying little bastards. And a friend of Dorothy is a euphemistic term describing someone who's gay, whilst a friend of John Richardson is a euphemistic term describing someone who's imaginary. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is John Richardson. In the Urban Dictionary, John means gift from God, although in his case, let's hope God's kept the receipt.
To listen to that, John.
I think your turn's coming, mate.
And John's teammate, Victoria Corin Mitchell. Victoria is the host of a highbrow intellectual quiz show called Only Connect. If you haven't seen it, it's like an upmarket version of Regular Countdown, but for an audience who might make it through next winter. Up against them this evening is Sean Locke.
Thank you.
When it comes to appearing on this show, Sean knows the winning formula, and that is two parts whiskey, three parts hand sanitizer. And joining Sean tonight is Henning Vane. Welcome to Countdown, Henning. I'd ask the audience to make Henning feel welcome tonight, but I know that 52% of them want him to piss off back to Germany. It is great to have you here tonight, Henning, because it'll be good to have a hostage when the war begins.
You really liked that, didn't you?
Henning, what was your take on the whole Brexit vote?
Well, you have to take the rough with the smooth, and there is upsides to living in an attic. It's all very peaceful. Might even get a book out of it. No, it's a right old shambles, and everyone who voted for Leave should be shot. But certainly have their heads examined. But it's the way it goes. It's democracy. Like it or loathe it, it's the way it goes.
Yep.
Did you vote? I think you've lived here.
Well,
for a long
time. Course not, because I'm not a citizen. I haven't had to vote.
Oh, you could have had mine.
Right, Sean, let me ask you this. Have you ever been psychoanalyzed? And if so, what were the results?
Well, yeah, I have actually. I've had psychoanalysis. I didn't want it. I just got all the psychiatric gift vouchers from my family. It was a Christmas present. They all clubbed together and bought me the psychiatric gift. I was really disappointed. I wanted a crossbow. But I went for a particular type of therapy. I went for Dickens therapy. It's called Dickens therapy. And what you do is you compare your life to that of a Victorian orphan. Turns out, everything's just dandy.
OK. John, summer's here. What have you got planned?
Don't really like summer, to be honest. It's difficult to find the right cardigan for the summer. Costing up weddings. I like to go to weddings and just think, oh, no one's touched them potatoes. That was a waste of money, wasn't it? I didn't used to know that, but since I got married, I look at everything now and I think, confetti, that's gone on the floor. That was a waste of money, wasn't it? No one noticed the cheese. They were shit-faced, to be honest. I saw one person leave with a full wheel of cheddar. So you wasted your time there. That was my wedding. Unbelievable. I said, take a bit of cheese. Anyway, it doesn't matter, does it?
Who took the cheese out of interest?
Oh, it was my wife's friends. I told them they could have it, but I didn't think they would take all of it. In a way, it was a good metaphor for being married. Take some, and then it all went. My soul, Jimmy. She's welcome to it. It's cursed.
Victoria, you're the host of Only Connect, and you've got a first in English from Oxford. Are you feeling confident?
This is the kind of thing you'd think I'd be good at, isn't it? It's the kind of thing you think I'd be good at.
I would think you'd be amazing at
this. It's a terrible mistake. You people would think, oh, she'd be good at that. You know, she can do numbers, she can do words, that's good. I'm now going to be beaten by somebody playing in their second language. Adopted.
And
Henning.
Very good, John.
Thanks, John.
No, mascots. John, have you brought a mascot this evening?
Well, oh, let's try that again. A little bit more masculinity. Well, what I'd like to do, Jimmy, if you don't mind, is just twank off for a minute.
What, sorry?
People who aren't on Twitter will know. If you thank someone on Twitter, that's called twanking. So I'd like to... I'd like to twank a few people, because people send me nice messages and it cheers me up. They're very sort of inspiring, so this is a message I got sent on the 29th of April. If John Richardson can make it into comedy, then so can anyone. This is one of my favourite tweets I've ever got. Fusion Jim, amazing meal at the Wharf, Manchester, with my good friend and comedian, John Richardson. Good to see you, mate. Never met this guy, never been to the Wharf in Manchester. This goes down as the scariest tweet I've ever had in my entire life. So this is coming from Darren Spanner. 3rd of September 2013. I've not blanked that out. There's nothing there. Just a blank tweet. That's the sort of Twitter equivalent of just sitting behind someone on a bus and going, eh. This guy joined Twitter in about 2011. I clicked on his page to see who he was. He's only ever tweeted once in the history of his account. And a man arrested for attempted murder. So a link to an attempted murder, and then a year later he's just gone, all right, mate. If I ever do go missing, just remember the name Darren Spanner, cos I'm probably in his fucking cellar. And then here we've got just a nice one to end on. Matthew Barker, he's watched my stand-up. Stick to the panel shows. Thanks for that. Will do.
Henning, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. Brought a family friend.
Oh, no.
That is my...
That's some German comedy.
That is my family friend, Uncle Monsters, and he's a very learned man, and hopefully he can help us this evening. Yeah, him. Can we get playing?
I'm sorry, is there more explanation as to why you put on a weird inflatable cat that you're clearly having sex with?
Well, what's surprising about this? It's an old family friend that doesn't have anywhere to stay and currently is staying at mine.
If someone switches on the programme halfway through, they'll be terrified that no one else can see it.
Is it a cat?
It is whatever you want it to be.
It to be gone.
Yeah, I'm not sure I've done myself a favour bringing him here.
Victoria, have you got a mascot?
Yes.
What did you bring?
I brought a dictionary.
That's what I should have brought, really, in hindsight.
Victoria's dictionary. Is it my own dictionary?
No way.
Yeah.
Right.
Includes all rude words. I've customised the cover. You see, it's got... I've done this over the years, various sort of creatures. It did have a Nike tick on it, but they said you can't have brand names, so I've just changed it into a swastika. So I've got that there, and, you know, if there's any disputes about any of my words, we'll just check.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes, Jimmy. What I thought I'd do is, you know, it's a very popular revenue stream for comedians stroke celebrities these days is children's books. There's a lot of readies in it. It's not a lot of work. You just write down anything that you think of. You get someone to draw some pictures.
Plenty Mulan, yeah.
Beep, beep, back it up, back it up. Beep, beep, beep. So I've written one, and I'm very excited about it. I think it's going to be popular with not just kids, but with their parents as well. And I've sort of reworked an old classic, and it is the tiger who came for a pint.
Oh,
It's a lovely story. It mixes up two of my favourite things, which is tigers and alcohol. I'll read the story to you now. I've got to use Susie's pen cam. The tiger who came for a pint. Now, there was once a tiger who fancied a pint. Not Carling, of course. That was too weak and too gassy. He wanted a pint that packs a punch like Stella or Cronenberg. The tiger was thirsty and needed something to wash down the zookeeper he'd just eaten. He liked the atmosphere of Wetherspoons. Plus, he was barred from the King's Head for mauling the darts team. Tiger drank his pint quietly beside the quiz machine. Soon, what with the beer, fags and flame-grilled McCoys, he'd spent all his money. But he didn't half have a thirst on. So, when George went to the cellar to flush out the Strongbow line, the tiger drank all the beer from all the kegs and all the rum they were saving for Caribbean night. Then he ate the meat raffle. A very naughty tiger. Then he went to toilet on the bar. This is going to sell millions. We're going to have to call you a minicab home, tiger, said George, the deputy manager, bursting from the cellar. Where do you want taking? To the zoo, you silly bollocks. So George, the deputy manager, called the tiger a cab. It took a while to get one because the first two drivers they sent said, are you mental? Finally, Pavel from Station Cars agreed to take the tiger. The journey went smoothly and eventually, after a lot of questioning, the tiger said, look, for the last time, it's not a onesie. Wetherspoon's deputy manager George never saw the tiger or Pavel, the station's car's driver, ever again. Yeah.
Over in Victory Corner, it's Tom Allen.
Oh.
Fun fact, Tom didn't appear at the Edinburgh Festival for 3 years. Instead, he went on a gay cruise. And if you're having trouble remembering that fact, just keep repeating to yourself the key points over and over again. Gay Tom Cruise. Gay Tom Cruise. For people that don't know you, how would you describe yourself?
Still gay. I would say I think I'm quite camp. Was that fair to say?
That's a pretty good description, I would say. Tom, would you describe yourself as a people person?
Yes, I love company, but I can't stand other people. Like, recently, I saw a man with a bag for life from Lidl, and you just wish some people believed in themselves a bit more.
Nothing wrong with Lidl.
Nothing wrong with
Lidl?
No, nothing. Anyway, have you ever been in a Lidl?
No. Are you being serious? I haven't been in a Waitrose, mate.
Have you not? Where'd you get your vegetables from?
They're in the kitchen. Okay. I'm with Tom, of course, it's Susie Dent. There she is. Susie's written 13 books. They say everyone's got one good book inside them, so fingers crossed for the next one, Susie. Now, when was the last time you saw a word and you didn't know what it meant?
All the time, especially if it's rude. Show me anything in the Urban Dictionary and normally I have to ask Rachel what it means.
I liked it when you asked, why is it called teabagging?
Yeah. Teabagging. Didn't get that one. And then didn't I say I was so hungry you'd find me munching the carpet?
OK. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley! Rachel is every man's dream if that man is dreaming about an unattainable maths genius who shit at dancing. Rachel, Victoria is new to the show. Have you got any advice for her?
Yeah, well, me and Susie, we love Victoria, so basically we'll do anything you want.
Well, it's absolutely mutual, and I'd like to congratulate your wife that was a very elegant 387 in an earlier show. That was very nicely done, very nicely arrived at.
Very nicely arrived at was a sexual compliment in Victorian times. I thought you arrived at that very well. Yes.
Have you alighted? Yes, I have.
Years and years ago, when I was a teenager, I wrote occasionally for the Daily Telegraph, and I once got... I got a letter, filthy letter, from a gentleman who told me in his opening line that he was 85, and he'd put all the rudest words in Latin.
Oh, nice.
I genuinely can't think of anything filthier.
It's a weird thing to do, Sean. Why'd you do it?
I speak a Latin, that's how I...
Yes, Sean, they're doing the Latin accent.
Come and go, eh? Bada bing. That's Latin, isn't it?
Okay, and the prize the teams will be competing for tonight, it's the Countdown Surfboards. Okay, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and Victoria, you're first to pick the letters.
Please.
This is so exciting! Could I have a consonant, please?
You can indeed. S.
And then a vowel.
O.
And then another consonant.
L. Go for a vowel?
Vowel, yeah.
A.
Two more consonants.
D and T.
Another consonant.
R.
And two vowels.
And... E and I.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. John, how many letters?
Well, I've definitely got an 8, but I think I might have a 9, but I've spelt it wrong.
What are you going to go for, an 8 or a 9?
I'm going to try the 9.
Oh! OK, Victoria.
I think there might be 9s, but I'm going to safety play with 8.
But if you have a 9, go for a 9.
No, 8.
Why would you not?
8.
I'll come back. Henning.
I'm not going to win this. I've got 6.
OK. Sean?
6.
Victoria, I'll ask again.
I thought there was a 9, but then I needed 2 eyes to do it.
You've got 4 eyes, mate.
Put a fez on. Put a fez on.
Victoria, how many? 8 or 9?
8.
All right, Henning.
Stride.
OK. Sean?
Soiled.
Victoria.
Isolated.
Isolated.
Excellent.
That's a word.
Oh, you got an excellent from Susie.
Yeah.
John?
Is there a 9 there, Susie?
Yes, there are quite a few. Yeah.
Oh, that's going to really piss me off. I've got idolaters.
Brilliant.
Yeah. No, you got a 9. Oh, come on. More. You. John Richardson.
What does it mean?
Susie?
Idolaters. Yeah, people who worship other people, like John.
Well, you got a 9, and it's double points for a 9, so that's 18 points! OK, on to our first numbers round. OK, Sean and Henning, your turn to pick the numbers.
Numbers now?
Yeah. 2 big, 4 small.
2 big, 4 small, coming up. And they are 10, 6, 1, 5... And the big one, 75 and 50.
So what are we aiming for?
Aiming for that one.
That's doable.
544.
Your time starts now.
That's
I've got it!
Mm.
I've got it! On the nose.
Have you?
Yeah!
Oh, great.
Let's squirt in fast.
Great. You sure?
Give or take.
OK, so the target was 544. Henning, did you get it?
It needs to be verified, but I'm fairly hopeful.
Sean, did you get it?
Well, I stopped, because he kept going, I've got it! I've got it! So I just thought, there's no need.
Keep your powder dry.
Oh, John, did you get it?
Yes.
Victoria?
Yes.
OK. Seems like it was an easy one, Henning, but how did you do it?
With elegance. 50 times 10. Plus 75, minus in brackets 5 times 6, minus 1.
Right.
Yep, lovely. Don't need the brackets, but why not?
Vicky, did you get?
Yeah, 50 plus 5 times 10, take away 6.
Lovely.
10 points to both teams. The scores at the moment, Sean and Henning have 10, John and Victoria have 28. And here is your teaser. The words are grab oral. The clue is man's best friend. That's grab oral, man's best friend. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were drab oral. The clue was man's best friend. It was, of course, Labrador. So, John and Victoria are in the lead. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Victoria and Henning. So, Victoria, your turn to choose the letters.
Oh, vowel, please.
U.
Consonant.
B.
Vowel. Henning's hoping you'll bring out an O with an umlaut. Two more consonants, please.
M and R.
Two vowels.
That's the American president there.
An I.
And two consonants.
And the last one's D and N.
OK, and your time starts now. Victoria, how many letters?
I was very distracted by that, so only 7, but it should be more.
OK, Henning.
Well, yeah, I struggle against someone that goes, ooh, unfortunately, only a 7, I was distracted. I've got good and honest 5.
Good and honest 5. What is your 5, Henning?
Rumba. Rumba, the dance.
OK. And then, Victoria, what's your...
Well, I'd like to point out that you can make the 6-letter word remain, which I'd like to have done.
Oh, yeah! That sounds to me like 48% of the audience clapping.
But purely for the points, I'll say brained.
Susie, brained?
Yeah, absolutely fine. Brained someone. Henny, you could have put an ED on rumba and had rumbered, as in they rumbered all night.
See, that isn't a word. I mean, that is just playing silly buggers, isn't it? I mean...
Would you have preferred bandier, as in bandier legs? That's also a 7. Like, he's got bandy legs, but here's a bandier.
It's also what they shout when you try and get in a pub, but you're not allowed in. They go, you can't come in, you're bandier.
Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Oh, sure. unarmed.
Yes.
unarmed.
But seven was still tops.
OK. So at the end of that round, Sean and Henning have 10, John and Victoria have 35. John and Sean to go head-to-head. Sean, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'll have one from the top and then hit me with what you got from below.
Wow, it makes it sound so sexy. OK, everything from below, we have 5, 3, 6, 8.
Just normal numbers again, isn't it? Yeah.
And the big one, 25. Target 173.
Okay.
I get there.
Your time starts now. OK, your target was 173. Sean, did you get it?
Yes, I did, Jimmy.
John, did you get it?
Yes, I did, Jimmy.
Well, Sean, how did you get it?
3 plus 4 is 7.
Yep. So it is.
Times 25 is 175. 8 minus 6 is 2.
Yep.
You take that off and you get 173.
Do.
What have you got, John?
I did it the same way, but a bit more camp.
OK. 10 points to both teams. OK, so Sean and Henning have 20, John and Victoria have 45. 45. Time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Tom, what have you got for us?
Oh, Jimmy, thank you for throwing to me. Hello. Now, relationships are difficult for everyone, whether you're gay or straight or bi or any of the other ones. The main pressure is distracting yourself from the one other person who you've grown to hate. Now, there are many elements of living with a partner. For example, redecorating. Now, for straight people, redecorating is often just standing in a home base and shouting, "No, Gary, not them tiles! The ones I circled in the brochure! Oh, for fuck's sake!" Whereas for gay people, it's more like, "Oh, no, we can't have any of these tiles. They're from home base." Also, eating out is an important part of the lifestyles of many couples because it allows them both to socialise and, more importantly, to show off. For straight people, it's a lot like, "Do you want to go Carluccio's?" "Oh, yeah, sure. I love it up the looch." For gay people, it can take months of planning and research and trying to find somewhere that doesn't serve push-button coffee. For example, Malcolm, Denise has given us tickets to see Elaine Page's biographical show, Page by Page by Page. "What, Clive? But you promised we could go to that pop-up restaurant that's just popped up? You know how I love to eat Stratford." "Stratford? Where the Olympics were?" "No, not Stratford, Clive. Stratford? Food you eat on the Strat?" "Oh, street food." "But I hate street food, Andy. I hate cocktails out of jars. I hate chips out of plant pots. And I hate pulled pork off a roof tile. And I like to eat indoors because I'm not homeless."
Come on, everyone. Come on. Here's your teaser. The words are semi-toss. The clue is damp to the touch. That's semi-toss, damp to the touch. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were semi-toss. The clue was damp to the touch. It was, of course, mossiest. Victoria, are you happy with your teammate? Do you feel he's bringing you down?
No, I think Only Connect teams and viewers would say John Richardson is very much our kind of guy. So I'm very happy to be on his team.
The rest of us wouldn't be right for that show.
Yeah.
Well, Well, it'd be nice to have you there, Jimmy, just to look pretty. You know, just to brighten up the set.
There's three of us. We could go on, the three of us.
Hang on, I'm just going to go through my diary here. Oh, no, God. No. Oh.
You are a busy boy, aren't you?
Oh, God, no. I'd love to, guys. Oh, maybe there's... Oh, God, no, it's Lammastide.
Right, now it's time for John and Henning to go head-to-head. John, your turn to choose the letters.
Thank you, Jimmy. I would like a vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, John. O.
And I would like a consonant, please.
C.
And another vowel, please.
Hello, Joe.
All right, Jimmy. Oh, God, sorry, I shouldn't really be drink driving. There we are. Oh, good Lord.
Why are you here, Joe? You don't work here anymore.
Oh, yeah. God, you're thick as pig shit, aren't you? that shouldn't be smoking. I dropped my fag in there earlier. I'm doing a bonus round, Jimmy.
But we don't have a bonus round.
Do you not?
No.
Shit. I'll be honest with you, that's pissed me off a little bit. I drove this up from South London. It took me. I caused 111 accidents. And it's Fabio's birthday. That's rude.
Joe, can I ask why Fabio's got a toilet seat around his neck?
It's what he wanted for his birthday. He's a fucking idiot. Come on, lads, let's go. Jimmy's an arsehole. Right.
Hold on. Do you want to see the bonus round?
I'm not doing it. I've got some dignity, you know.
Joe?
Hmm?
I'll give you this jar of gherkins if you do it.
Go on, then! Let's go! Countdown
on the whole game! Hello
there. Pop yourself on, lads. Go on.
No.
Hello there.
On your pop. You can have Gavin or Fabio. It's up to you. That's Gavin. You have to sit on his lap.
Okay.
It's
what it's right was that?
Okay, cheek, yeah. Cheek to balls.
Joe?
Yes, love.
Is your train called the Hot Guy Express?
Yes, it is.
Woo-hoo!
Are we nearly there yet?
Oh yes.
I'm quite a way off, if I'm honest.
Right. Can you pop some letters on? Let's go with this shit.
Is it still John?
No, pop them on, love. Who gives a shit? by the way, my face is a U.
U?
I don't make the rules.
Of course it is.
Hurry up, love. Desperate for a piss.
E. M. Ooh, that's a good one. Ooh. And V.
Let's do this.
Okay, and your time starts now.
So what do you reckon then?
Thank you.
John, how many letters?
I think a five.
Henning? I've got a five.
All right, Henning, what's your five?
Mouse or rouse.
Yeah. Mouse or rouse.
Oh, you got cum with my face on it.
Okay, John, what's your five?
I think it's the only thing I'm not covered in. Mucus.
You haven't seen your back, John. Well, 5 points to both teams.
I tell you what, I had a beetroot salad for tea, and that was a much more uncomfortable experience for Fabio than it was for me.
Tom, could they have done any better?
I was rather excited about the Hot Guy Express, but I...
As was Susie, you know what she's like.
Six letters. Mouser?
Mm.
Yeah. And covers. There's another one you could have had. Six letters, covers.
OK, the scores at the moment, Sean and Henning have 25, John and Victoria have 50. OK, time to go across to Victory Corner again. Tom, what have you got for us?
Welcome back. Now, for some people, holding a hand on a hot stove is a great way for them to remind themselves that they're still alive.
Are you reaching out to John?
Jimmy, how dare you interrupt me? So, do you want to do some sort of badinage then? I don't really enjoy it.
Coming on the show is absolutely screwing up. My brain just screamed, badinage. Is that an anagram of beading? I'll never be normal again. I shouldn't have come.
Hold on, Susie. Is badinage an anagram of beading?
Hang on, this is my bit. For me, I love to go to fancy dress parties. Now, for some people, fancy dress spells fancy stress because they do not know who to go as. Now, in that instance, all I would say is thank God for Jane Asher. And that's not actually the first time I've said that this week. Jane Asher's fancy dress is a Bible for people who love to party. But who have too much time on their hands. James' first suggestion is maybe you'd like to go to a fancy dress party dressed as a soda stream. As Jane puts it, transform some strips of polystyrene packaging material into a magical bubbling fountain. Oh, so magical. Get into a passionate embrace with this one and you'll find the popping of bubbles both exciting and stress-relieving. Now, if you don't like that, maybe, you know, that feels a bit strange to go dressed as that and you want something that's, I don't know, maybe a bit more fabulous, but also it's great for people who hate the Atkins diet. And this outfit is to go as a sandwich.
My mum dressed me up as that. It's an egg salad sandwich. My mum has that exact book. And
Rachel, this is my bit!
You just brought back horrible memories
from my
childhood.
Did you go dressed as a salad sandwich?
An egg salad sandwich. There are photos.
Oh, that's nice. So she did it?
There's a circus tent in there. She did that one as well.
Thank you, Rachel. OK. Hear that, everybody. So if you're still not sure, now this one you will find very surprising. Now this final winning outfit, I think you're gonna like this, Jimmy. If you're not sure, if you're feeling a bit self-conscious about what to go as, maybe you just go as a whacking grape circus tent. Finally, both a winning outfit and a solution to the housing crisis. As Jane describes it, it's perfect. It's perfect for a pregnant lady. The sight of someone pregnant is disgusting and must be hidden. Now, remember, all you need to make these things, all you need to make these things are just 3.5 metres of white sheeting, 7 metres of trimming, 2 garden sticks, 4 paper plates, a sewing machine, a welder, a chainsaw, a 5-year textiles degree, a fully equipped workshop, and a small factory in Bangladesh.
Teaser. The words are dog smear. The clue is wipe it down afterwards. That's dog smear. Wipe it down afterwards. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were dog smear. The clue was wipe it down afterwards. It was, of course, orgasm.
Sorry, one quickly. I just realised I haven't got you a... Do you want a can?
Yeah, of course, darling. Thank you.
Sorry, that's very rude. Of... He makes some noise, doesn't he?
Time for our final letters game. Sean and Henning, your turn to choose the letters.
Mm. Rachel. Joe.
Sean.
Yes, love.
Just give us what you feel like. Just do it. You do it.
How strong is that lager?
You've fallen out of your shoes.
Yeah.
Drop the other one and you look as if you're coming back from a hen do.
That'll do. Got loads of those this year.
Right. What was it?
So just do whatever you feel. Just
all right, I'm going to lob them about.
We'll stick them on the board. No!
Ironically, someone's just been blinded in the crowd by a flying eye.
You're doing really well. So we've got a P over here, an O, an E, a T, an S.
Let's fill it. Let's bloody fill it, top and bottom. There you go, that'll do.
OK.
That'll do,
OK, so you've got extra letters to work with.
Yeah.
All right, and your time starts now.
That is too many.
It is too many.
Good to get away. I brought people prezzies. I brought everyone something. I got you cream colon. Get involved. Feel free. Do you like sweets, don't you, Sean?
Mmm.
Plop. He loves a plop. Oh, sorry. Apologies. I got some of this. I make this myself, actually. It's sort of a garnish for crackers. So I don't know if you can see that. It's semen dip. I don't want that to spill. And then. It's a hot chili sauce with shrimp and fish. What would you call that? Shitto. Sean, how did you do?
I really struggled. I got 3.
There's poets there, mate.
OK. Henning, how did you get?
I'm not much better. All I've got is a 5, and that's exactly the 5 letters that are already there in
order. Well played, son. Well played. Yeah.
John, what'd you get?
I think I've got an 8.
You think you've got an 8?
Yeah.
OK. Victoria?
Oh, a 7.
A 7. OK. Well, let's hear your 3, Sean.
Well, it's something we all need. It's a tap.
Victoria.
Potties.
Potties.
Potties, like potties. Babies would use.
John?
Peakiest.
Oh, good, that's
peakiest.
Great.
Is it in there, Susie?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Thank you. Could they have done any better? Tom, yeah. Susie?
Could have got a 9.
And what was the 9?
Autopista.
Can you define that?
No. Susie can, though.
It's a motorway in Spain or Spanish-speaking country.
OK, so Sean and Henning have 25. John and Victoria have 58. OK, fingers on buzzers. It's time for our It's Never Been Less Crucial conundrum. Time starts now.
And what are we after?
A word.
There is one.
No, that's not a word.
Well, I never managed 9 letters ever.
Is it yellowing?
Let's take a look. Scores are Sean and Henning have 25 points. The winners with 68 points are John and Victoria. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of these Countdown surfboards. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful TV audience, and to all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Film prem J.J. Abrams directs But It Could Have Been Spielberg, an homage to the classic summer blockbuster Super 8, tomorrow night from 9. Next up on Channel 4, Friday Night Dinner and a huge family announcement for Pud.